Now.
Restore this pair of hustle loafers. Shell Cordovan from Florshine. Model 33870. Code KE. Same old. I'm gonna use a piece of. Kind of clean cloth, alcohol, IPA, you know, rubbing alcohol, clean the inside. Really well. Yeah. In. Doesn't matter because you know alcohol dries really quickly. So I want to you know strain the shoes out. I'm gonna use also rubbing alcohol. Spray the sole of the shoes. Like the outsole, not the insole. So I want to spray the outsole really, you know, wet, you know. So I'm going to straighten out the soles overnight. Now, I'm going to start cleaning the upper. Yeah. Pick a hairbrush. I like to clean up the upper with, you know, strip off the whole, the old layer of whatever the previous owner put on, because I don't like the original finish or anything that I don't know what's the previous owner put on the shoes. Why, you know, I don't have a shiny shoe. Let's just do it. You know, let's just brush the dirt off. I'd like to, you know, rub the upper until I see no more shiny spot. Or I can, you know, longer feel sticky. Touch it with my finger. Yeah, almost there. Moderate to firm pressure, but not too firm. nice. Almost all coming off. You know, while I'm waiting for that, just go a little bit on here. So it was soft enough, easier to do. Continue doing this. So it's raining outside. If you hear some clicking, it's raining. So yeah, this shoe looks pretty clean of any, you know, no more shiny spot except for this part. What they said, rub it hard till it come off. This should be clean of previous finish or whatever was put on them, on it. And check the sole. See, soak in. Apply another coat. Let them soak in. This is a 50-50 water and rubbing alcohol, in case you're curious. This is pure alcohol, so. Fast, firm stroke. Whoa, what's this? Oh, blue. Yeah. Some kind of glue stick out, so snip it off with a chisel. A sharp chisel. So I wouldn't care too much about cleaning up the tassels. Well, there's no need. They're gonna move around anyway, kicking around anyway. So, waste my time on them. So you may ask why I have to do this. So I already explained that I did like whatever Forsheim put on the shoes. And I don't know what the previous owner put on them. And after cleaning up like these, like this thing, I'll shine them up. You know, it takes extra work and time. But after shining them, I can, you know, I know for sure that this is the true real beauty of Cher Quarterbin. Excuse me, my pants. And I just don't get it why, I guess the reason that Forsheim, you know, or Allen Edmond, Alden, put a acrylic coating on the shoe is that, you know, to protect the shoes first, and then to keep the shoe shiny for a long time, because Cher Quarterbin is really hard to develop a good shine, so yeah. So why rubbing alcohols, you know? Rubbing alcohols, you know, works fine in your skin. So there's no reason that it does not work on Cher Quarterbin. And many people say that Cher Quarterbin is really this and that, you know, you don't want to put any harsh chemical on it. You know, Cher Quarterbin is really, has really tight structure. And it likes water. Actually, it's not. It doesn't like water. It's really strong against water. That's why, you know, there's a MAC method. That you just use a damp cloth, wipe it, and brush it. Check it, it's really dry. I'm almost done, hang on. And these Forsheim or Cher Quarterbin tassel loafers are pretty rare, but you know, I don't know, back in the days, Forsheim makes some of the best shoes ever. So if you find a pair, Cher Quarterbin from Forsheim, from the 1997 and back, you know, to the 60s, grab them if they're cheap, because they will last forever if with proper maintenance and care. And judging from this heel, I believe that the previous owner have this pair of shoes are from 1997 to like 1992 to like 97. Just, you know, because after 97, Forsheim moves their production over to India. Yeah. And this is still made in America. So new heel made in America. So around 92 to like 97. sorry if my accent might, you know, accent butt you, but that's what I was born with. I'm proud of it. I'm bilingual and would love to learn another language when I can make up some time in the future. The reason that I talk a lot is that a lot of, you know, YouTubers, subscribers complain that why, you know, my videos ASMR, but I never talk. Okay, I'll just talk. And if I receive too much, you know, too many complaints or negative feedback, I'll just stop talking. I'll just focus on shushang. Yeah, check my other videos. I think it should be fun. You should find something in there useful. So I'm done cleaning up, stripping off the acrylic finish or whatever finish that the previous owner put on them. Check the sole again. Still wet and a piece of paper. I'll leave them this dry overnight so they will strain out. And has enough time for them to dry off the leftover alcohol. Condition them next morning. See you again. So I'd like to polish this pair of floor shine charcoal Victus all over. So I already stripped these off in the previous segment and put one coat of Big Four leather conditioner on them. Pretty clean now, and especially the right shoes. I used a deer bow to smooth out all the rolls. You can see here the difference. It's really hard to see, but the left shoes still have some ridges, which I'm gonna do right now. So in the meantime, I'll do another coat of Big Four onto the right shoe and enjoy.